MNEK, Zara Larsson, Kiss FM, welcome.
Yay!
All right, I held out because I was like, are they going to be clappers for themselves? And MNEK was. Zara's like, I'm not going to clap for myself.
I'm that self-absorbed.
I always wonder.
Okay, a little bit after, but
yeah, it's all right, mate. Okay, all right, thanks for leaving me in hanging, guys.
There's no shame in the self.
Absolutely no shame. But some radio stations even have like a button they press and then they have like a fake audience.
No way.
Yeah.
Give me a second.
He's searching.
If some radio stations are going to do it, Kiss are going to do that. Should we do it again?
Do you have it? Okay.
Yeah. Right. MNEK, Zara Larsson.
Yay!
All right.
They're still going.
They love us. I'm going to do that every time.
Right. How are you guys? All right?
We're good, man. Yeah.
How are you finding it working together? Are you sort of like brother and sister yet? Are you at that stage where you're loving each other but sort of
falling out?
Zara is like my white Swedish sister and it's really great. And no, it's been really cool to like do promo together because like, you know, we kind of, we're doing our own things and it's really crazy, but it's great to have like us, you know, talking about the song as one unit.
Yeah.
Very exciting times.
Well, MNEK, you've been working so hard for, I don't know, how many years now? How many years would you say it's been?
It's been a moment.
It's been a long time. And finally, it's so great to have you out to the masses to hear you on the radio and stuff.
Thank you, man.
And Zara, I didn't realise, like, forgive me, but you are massive in Europe. Like, huge.
Well,
I've been doing some, like, creeping, stalking, research, whatever you want to call it. Can you take us back to what happened when you were 10 years old? I don't want to tell the story. What happened when you were 10? Like, okay. This is a
when
life-changing moment.
When I was 10, I participated in the Swedish version of Britain's Got Talent, basically. And I won it, which is so crazy. It's almost like 8 years ago. But after I expected a record deal. I expected so much to happen and nothing happened. And I was really, really disappointed. And I was just mad and heartbroken because
Slid.
I was like,
at the age of 10, you were feeling all these things.
I was like, oh my gosh, I'm not going to have a career. And now when I look back, I'm like, I was 10.
Yeah.
Like, of course, nobody wanted to sign me. But that was really, really fun. It was definitely a great experience.
Now, the Swedish connection is actually growing. Obviously, you're from Sweden. The connection was there from the start. Mm-hmm. But you've just gone gold in Sweden.
Yeah.
You're treating the rhythm. Little clap for that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's massive. So you're really growing out there right now. You're kind of like a big deal out in Sweden.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure sold more copies there than they did here. But
it's good. Amazing.
I mean, it's really great to have success there. And to get the plaque, you know, there was like the icing on the cake. It was incredible.
Now, where is that plaque going? That's the big question.
In my studio. Okay. Along with... I just got a plaque for Say Something.
Sweet.
For Karen Chin.
Yeah.
And what else? There's a lot of plaques there.
There's a lot of plaques already.
Yeah. But this is my first plaque as an artist, which means like so much more.
And if that's not a reason to go and buy Never Forget You, I don't know what is.
Oh.
Zara, MNEK, thank you so much for hanging out with us today.
Thank you
for having us, man.
Absolute pleasure.